Dear students, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In today's lecture, I am going to explain how to draw the different landscape elements in web presentation. In this lecture, we will know how to sketch trees, how to sketch persons or people, how to sketch floors, how to sketch cars, and finally rendering. Okay, first, how to sketch a tree. Here, as we see, different type of trees in plan. Okay, we can make all of this by using different techniques of pencil or different techniques of ink. How we draw these trees? By using this circular ruler. Okay, so first we must determine the scale of a floor plan. For example, if we are drawing 1 to 100, okay, 100. So the diameter of this tree must be suitable for the scale for plane, and we choose the suitable circle and we draw inside this circle. Okay, as we see here, different type, and we can add some shadow. We first draw the first one. Then we are moving the ruler here and draw the second one for the shading. Okay, here are different kinds of trees. Also here different kinds if we want to draw a group of trees together like this, or linear like this, or different types together, okay, or different size and types together. And here different kinds also, which we can draw using different techniques by pencil or by ink. Here by ink, we can draw this by ink. Same, we put also a circular ruler and we make these trees. And maybe we can add something for floors like here, or grass like here, okay, or like stone floor here, okay. And when we need to add shading, we have two types of shading. First, we draw the circle like this. After drawing circle, we add in details of the tree, and we make the second circle like this and like this. Or we can draw line. This line with angle 45 degree, as we said, we agree together that the sun rays for 45 degree. So we can draw from the diameter here, and we are drawing line up to this point and up to this point, and this is the shade for the tree. Or we can make the shade is parallel to the tree, only we are moving the circle and we draw this curved line, and we make it like we see here. This is a shading for the tree. Okay, we can make the shape with different techniques. Okay, cross line, dashed line, and lines, parallel lines, dotted, and so on, as we see here. Okay, so first we draw a circle, we adding the detail of the tree. Then we draw the shade. The shade with two kinds, maybe parallel or pointed or oriented to no point like this. How to make this point? Line 45 degree from this, or from the circle of the tree, and we make line from here to this point to this diameter. Okay. Okay. Same here. This is parallel lines technique. Okay. Is here dotted and pointed, and here is crossing line. Okay, also we can make the same tree, but we can add any color like this. These colors may be watercolors or you can colors or pencil colors, as much as you can. You can make different colors as we see here. Okay, this is the tree in plan. So the tree here, we can make it like this, and we make shading like parallel or oriented to point. Okay, the details of tree different as we see here, or we can make it this using ink, and after that we can add any color as we see. Now this in elevation, okay, same. This is how to draw this one. We starting with this. This is the skeleton of the tree. We added branches, and after that the leaves, as we see here, more details and shading, and we finalized the tree. Of course, it will take time from you first time, but after that it will be very simple. Okay. If you need to make like this one, so you must draw the border like here, then details. The border of this one like cone, and after that you can fill inside this cone all details and the other one. And so if like groups of leaves together and the branches, so this is the group, and inside each group you can fill what you need. And here, okay, this is ink techniques or pencil techniques. You hear ink techniques, pencil techniques. Also we can use here, as we see, color techniques. These colors are watercolors. Okay, of course, when you need to use watercolor, you must make practice more time to be professional, okay, in order to not damage your drawing. You must make a lot of time to practice before starting. Here some kinds also, okay, as we see very beautiful examples. So this is pencil technique, this is ink technique, this is color technique. You can use any one according to your project. Okay, also here, this is the first what you can make training for this in order to be professional. Okay, so we draw the groups of leaves, we draw the skeleton of the tree. After that we start adding some details and finalize the tree. Okay, this is different kinds. Here like cone, here like cone, and here like rectangle, and we make details inside this border as we see. Okay, very easy, but you must try to draw it by yourself. If you want to draw a group of trees, okay, like this here, okay, like this one, and as we see different kinds and different heights, don't make your trees is the same line or the same kind. You must use different kinds, different heights, as we see like this and here also. Okay, it gives beautiful your make your project is more beautiful without these elements. Here some sketches. If you draw some sketch, you can draw it this very fast. Here, as we see, this is our student. Okay, as we see her tree, she draws a tree, she make using ink, and after that she adding some colors to the tree. As we see, this is in plane, and here in elevations, different kinds, different colors, different techniques, as we see. Okay, here some persons, people, and we will speak about this later. Here another one in elevation. Okay, look for the tree. This is the skeleton, and this is here leaves and branches. And look, here is lighter and here darker. Okay, so when you make colors, don't make all the trees the same quality or the same tone of colors, but make from light to dark, from light to dark, and so on. Everyone, you can use this color, green color, or you can use this color, it's okay. Here in plants, how to make it in plants, different presentation of tree, different groups, okay, different size, all of this by using a circular ruler. And this is people, and we will see it later. Okay, also you need to draw some arrows in order to show the orientation, the north, the bitstream, ممرات المشاة, and so on. So you must to train how to draw these arrows, and this one also. And here, this is the example for bubble diagram. Bubble diagram, this means what is the main elements of the project and what are the different relations between each other. And here, for example, this is the entrance. Okay, this is waiting area. Okay, and here some rooms. So these rooms must be connected with this one by this circulation element. And we have circulation element here in order to reach to this space. And this space here mean distribution space. And from here, we have some links to go here and here and here. This mean this element must be connected with this one, but no need to make connection between this element and this element. Okay, here also, when we want to make a bubble diagram for group of buildings, for example, I have building here and building here and building here, and I want to make the relations between different buildings. So, for example, here we have a corridor of path here, big one, and here some another one. These arrows, okay, from here, you can use any type of these arrows here in order to show the different kinds of relation. And for example, this relation is very important. This is semi important. This is weak. Okay, and so on. Okay, so this bubble diagram for one building, and here for the relation between buildings and your site, and so on. You must make training to know how to draw this. Of course, these arrows and this bubble diagram, you can draw it using pencil or using ink or color, as we see here. For landscape element also, you can, for example, if you have some landscape elements beside your buildings, you can use like this. This is watercolor and pencil color presentation, as we see here. And this is using watercolor, as we see, very simple and very beautiful examples. You must train, you must know that as much as you can to use your handmade, your drawing will be life, you'll be alive, okay? So as much as you can, you must depending on your hand, okay? In first and second years, you must use your hand, because Design Studio 1 and Design Studio 2, you must submit in handmade without any computer program. So you must be professional in architectural drawing skills in order to this course will help you preparing the Design Studio 1 and Design Studio 2. Also, when you make a design, design concept, for example, when you are preparing the design concept in Design Studio 3, 4, 5, 6, even if you are working in any office and you want to make or prepare the design concept for a client, okay, first you must draw like this by your hand, and after take approval from the client, you can start finish your drawing using computer program. So sketches, drawing skills, it's very important for each one forever, not only for design 1 or 2, but forever still you are inshallah working in architecture. Very simple examples, palm trees look from lighter to darker, as we see here in plants. Okay, this is some examples, color examples. Very simple, you must training for how to draw this. Okay, persons, you can draw persons without any details. We don't need to draw all details, and you must know that the height of person is depending on your skill of drawing. If you are drawing with a scale 1 to 100, so this height must be 1.8 centimeter, because in reality the person height is 1.8. This is the standard, okay? 1.8 meter, okay? But if you are drawing 1 to 50, so you must double this height, so it will be 3.6 centimeter and so on. The height, you must obtain the height first. It is depending on the project scale. Okay, this is different types. Okay, this is more details. You can make it for perspective. Yani the previous one for elevation, for section, but here you can draw it in perspective. Why? Because its volume is big, not like that one. So in perspective, if the person is near to your eye, so he will be bigger than the previous one. So if bigger, so you must draw some details. And here is far from the observer, but here is near to the observer, so we have some details like we see here. And also here we see some details here also, okay, which we can add in order when we are drawing in perspective. Here in elevation and section, as we see, very simple one, okay, different culture. If Gulf countries, so we can draw like this, and this is very simple. And I said, don't forget that the height is depending on your scale of drawing, okay, and different position, sitting or worker or going or something in bank, in administration, okay, officer, and so on. So you must make training for this one. You can draw it in any paper, and a lot of times after that you will be professional, inshallah, for drawing these things. Different floors. Okay, we have floors inside the building and the floors outside the building. Okay, so you can make any design you need like this. This one using parallel lines, as we see, and we make a groove here with shaded, okay, in order to make a design. This is another one, different kinds of floors outside the building, as we see. Okay, maybe it's only square or net shabaka like this. Okay, this is a different one. You can make it using different techniques by pencil or by ink. Cars, it's very important also to training to draw the car. Okay, this is the different kinds of cars, different positions, and with details or without any details. Of course, if you will using a watercolor or color, no need to add these lines, only like this, and then you use colors to color this one. In plan, okay, you draw first this one, very simple lines. After that, you adding the details. Okay, in elevation, you draw this one and adding the details. Inside elevation, you draw this one, and after that, the details. Here, different type of car, it's plan, it's side view, back view, and elevation, another one, and so on. Okay, so start with this one in order to make or to be familiar with the dimension of the car. Choose the very simplest one, and after that you can draw any one from this. For perspective, it's very important. The car is like books, so you can draw the books of the car first, adding details, okay, adding details, and this is the final one, and after that you can add in the shading as we see here. But you are starting with books and starting with adding some details like glasses, like doors, and so on, wheels, and after that finishing the model. Okay. Of course, the vanishing point of cars. Okay, it must be the same vanishing point for the building. Okay. Here we start like this, adding wheels, adding glass and some details, mirror, and so on, and this is the final one. So look, this is the start point and this is the end point. Very simple if you try to make like this. But if you are looking like this, you will ask yourself, how I'm starting, how I can draw this, it's very difficult. No, no, you must start from here up to here, inshallah, will be your results. Okay, different kinds also. You can train yourself like this. Okay, so in today's lecture, we explained how to draw sketch, how to sketch trees in plane, how to sketch trees in elevation, and how to use different kinds of techniques for presentation trees, using pencil techniques, using ink techniques, using watercolor and different color techniques. After that, we saw sketches of person, how to draw persons, and we said, make attention to the scale or height of the person, 1.8, and in depending on the scale of your drawing. After that, different types of floors, and we said there are inside or internal floors and outside floors. Also, you can use different techniques of pencil and ink to draw the floors, and we draw the sketch cars, how to draw the different kinds of cars. In next lecture, inshallah, we will see how to make rendering for our project. Thank you, and I hope you had understood our today's lecture. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.